Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to English class. So yesterday we are going to listen. What is that? A true friend story. I was explaining a true friend story. So in that, I told you characters are there: hawk, she-hawk, and pelican, tortoise, lion, and so the group of tribal people. So now, first of all, I will show those pictures. Okay, everyone. Look at the screen. I'll show the pictures. Don't draw anything, ma. Okay, just look at the screen. Don't touch the screen. Okay. First, I'll show you hawk picture. Okay. Hawk. Have you seen that picture, ma? That is hawk. Okay, the main character of the story is hawk. So next picture, she-hawk. So that hawk wanted to marry the she-hawk. This is called she-hawk. Okay, have you seen the picture? This is she-hawk. Okay, next I will show the picture of tortoise, who is a friend of the hawk. Hawk's first friend. It is a tortoise. Okay. Hawk made friendship with a tortoise. And next picture. Pelican. Do you know I told you bird. Pelican is one of the bird. It is the second friend of the hawk. Okay. This is pelican. Next. Lion. This is the third friend of the hawk. Okay. Hawk made friendship with the lion, who is the king of the forest. The lion is the king of the forest. Have you seen the picture? Okay, next. I'll show you tribal people who they came to forest for hunting animals. So these are the tribal people. Okay, hunters. They are the hunters and tribal people. And next picture. So those are the young hawks. Hawk and she-hawk get married. Then they have children. So those are the young hawks. Now is it clear, students? Okay, hawks are the birds. Okay. So those are the characters of the story. Hawk, she-hawk, and next to tortoise, pelican, lion, and tribal people, tribes, a hunter, and young fox, and hawk. Okay, that means children. Baby hawks are the hawk and she-hawk. Okay, so what happened in the previous class? Hawk wanted to marry she-hawk. So hawk went to meet she-hawk. Then he proposed to she-hawk. What he proposed? Will you marry me? Then what she-hawk replied? Do you have friends? It asked him, do you have a friends? Then hawk replied that I don't have any friends. Then she-hawk said that if you make friends, then I will marry you. So then hawk went to the forest, around the forest, and he searched another tortoise. Where it searched the tortoise? Near the pond, lake. Near the lake, tortoise, he found tortoise, and hawk made friendship with a tortoise. After that, he was flying around the forest. Then he find one of the pelican. Pelican means one of the bird. So hawk made friendship with a pelican. So after that, he was going through the forest. And he made friendship with the lion. Who is the lion? Okay. Who is the lion? A lion is the king of the forest. So hawk made friendship with lion. Then how many friends that hawk has? How many friends? Show me with your fingers. Come on, students. How many friends hawk has now? Nobody showing. Come on, fast. Show your fingers. How many friends Hawk has? Very good. Very good, Suresh. Hawk has three friends. Who are they? Tortoise, pelican, and lion. It has three friends. Then Hawk went to She-Hulk and said that now I have three friends. Tortoise, pelican, lion. Now, will you marry me? That Hawk asked to She-Hulk. Then She-Hulk agreed to marry Hawk. Then soon they get married. Then they have a children. That means they have a family. Hawk and She-Hulk got married. Now they have eight hawks. So they made a nest near the lake. Wait. Near the lake where tortoise is living. Tortoise is living in near the lake. So wherever the tortoise is living there is another big tree. So all the tree, they made a nest. Nest means the house of a bird. Do you know that? Nest. These two got married and they made a nest. Nest means a house of a bird. Okay. Like you also have houses, like the birds have houses. What are their houses? Those are the nests. They made nest on the branch of a tree. Okay. So they made the nest. Hawk and She-Hulk made a nest and they have children. These children and these two are living in the nest. Okay. Where is that nest? Near the lake. The nest is near the lake. Where tortoise is living in the lake? We know that. Already I explained that tortoise is living in the lake. Okay. So there is a tree. On the tree they made a nest. Okay. So what happened one day? Tribal people came. Hunters. Who are the tribal people? Hunters. Hunters means who can catch the animals. Okay. So these hunters came to forest for a searching of a animals. What happened? Whole day they searched for the animals, but they did not get any animals. They did not hunt, unable to hunt any animals. So they were tired. Okay, whole day they worked, that's why they get tired. So they wanted to take rest. That's why they came under the tree where these are living, Hawk and Hawk's family is living. So that tree, under that tree, the tribal people came and they are sitting under the tree. They are sitting there. So that was the whole days. Those are the whole days. That's why they made a fire. They brought some of the firewood and they made a fire. So if we made a fire, what will happen? The heat will come. Am I right? The heat will come. So the fire is raising. That's why, because of that heat, the ant hawks, which are living under the in the nest, what happened? Because of the heat, these ant hawks are crying. Okay, these ant hawks are crying because they are unable to bear that heat. What will happen if the heat reaches that baby hawk? They will burn. Am I right? Those birds will burn and they will die. Okay. You know, because of the heat, those small birds, you know, young hawks, the smallest birds. So, if the heat reaches the nest, the birds are under the nest. Okay. The heat is coming from here down. So, what will happen? Because of the heat, the young babies of hawks, they will die. So that's why, because of that, unable to bear that heat, and those birds are chirping. Screeching means crying with a pain. Okay, they are screeching, they are crying, these birds are crying. So what happened that time? The hawk and the babies are crying. So next we will see. So yesterday I explained up to here. They raised the fire because of the heat. The birds, young birds, are screeching. Okay. Next. See that. Page number 13. Open page number 13 from your textbook. Now from the second paragraph I'm reading. Oh, so birds are here. We will light the flame, and the birds in the nest will be cooked well. When the flame reaches up, then we will eat them. One of them said. Saying this, hawk went to the pelican for help. The pelican took water in her beak from the lake and tried to douse the fire. What happened? When the fire reaches to the nest, these birds are chirping. These birds are crying. So if they are chirping or crying, what will happen? The sound will come. Am I right? The chirping of the birds will, screeching of the birds, the tribal people heard. These tribal people heard the cries of the young hawks. And they understand that. So, on the tree there is a nest. In that nest there are some birds. You know people eat birds? Do you know that? Like we are eating chicken. Like that some people will eat birds also. You know that? They catch the birds and they will cook a curry and they will eat the birds. You know that? Yes. So those tribal people, actually they did not get any animals there. So they are hungry and they are also tired. So by hearing the sounds of these birds, they felt very happy. One of the tribe from this group, one of the persons said that, oh, here are the birds. If we raise the fire, what will happen? Those birds will be cooked. Okay. Those birds which are in the nest. Those birds will be cooked and we will eat them. We will eat them so that we will pacify our hunger. They thought like that. Okay. So one of the tribe said that, one of the hunters said that we will raise the fire. How will we raise the fire? If you put some of the firewood, what will happen? The fire will be raised up to the nest. Okay. So if the fire will be raised up to the nest, what will happen? The birds which are in the nest, they will be dying. They will be cooked. They will be burned. Okay. If they burn, what will happen? These people will eat those birds. Okay. So one of the person said that we will raise the fire. Then the birds will be cooked. We will eat that. So then what happened? We will see here. Next paragraph. Saying this, the hawk went to the pelican for help. The pelican took water in her beak from the lake and tried to douse the fire. So the birds are chirping, the birds are screeching, crying. So seeing that, this hawk, that means father of these birds, that means this bird, dad, hawk went to take help from the pelican. This hawk went to the pelican and asked the pelican for help, because pelican is the friend of hawk. You know that? Pelican is hawk's friend. So hawk went to take help from pelican. Pelican means bird, which has a long beak, just I showed white color bird, which has a long beak. Have you seen that beak? How is that beak? Like this. It has a long beak. Pelican has, the bird has a long beak. So the hawk went to the pelican for help. What help it asked to? Save my children. They were young hawks because they made the fire. So because of the heat, these birds are crying. They will be dying. Please help me. That hawk asked to pelican. So by listening, that pelican went to the lake. There is a lake near the tree. You know that where tortoise is living in the lake. So pelican went to the lake. Pelican went to the lake. Then he took water from the beak. Beak means nose. Nose of the bird. He took water in his beak and put on the fire. He brought the water in his beak and put on the fire. What will happen if you pour the water on the fire? The fire will put up. Am I right? The fire will put up. If you pour the water on the fire will be put up. So that's why he brought water It is big and four are the five. What will happen if it is small? Like it has a, you know, birds are smallest birds. If it bring the water, how much water it will bring? Little water it will bring. But the fire is very high. Okay. So can it put up that fire? It was bringing water and pouring on the fire. It is bringing on the water and pouring on the fire. Bringing from the lake, the water, the pelican brought water from the lake and pouring on the fire. But it was tired for bringing water. Okay. So little water it is bringing. How many times it will go to the lake? How many times it will bring? So by bringing that water to put up that fire, the pelican was tired, becoming tired. So by seeing that, hawk thought of a plan. And next, second time, this hawk went to the tortoise for help. And said that the tribal people came and they made a fire under the tree. Because of that fire, my children are crying. That means young hawks are crying. They will die. Please help me. Already pelican is helping me, but it was tired to bringing the water. Please help me. Said to the tortoise. Hawk said to the tortoise. So what did the tortoise do at the time? Tortoise brought some of the mud from the lake and put up on the fire. Okay. Put on the fire. Tortoise brought some of the mud in his mouth. You know tortoise? So, in tortoise brought some of the mud. Mud means the dirty water. Okay. It brought dirty water from the lake and put up on the fire. Okay. Fire is here. The grate is like this. Okay. If it put some of the firewood, the grate is high. So, first pelican brought water and put on the fire. Second, what happened? Tortoise brought some of the mud and pour on this fire. So while the tortoise brought mud and pouring on the fire, what happened? We will see in the next video. Okay? Okay. She tried again and again, but men added more wood to the fire. So the pelican got tired of flying between lake and the fire, seeing the hawk clinging to the tortoise for help. The pelican helped a lot to put out the fire that could kill my young ones, but she is getting tired now. Can you lend a helping hand? Hearing this, the tortoise took some mud from the lake in his mouth and tried to douse the fire. Seeing the large tortoise, the hunters tried to catch him, but the huge tortoise dropped them into the water due to his strength. The hunters were drenched. So they left the tortoise and came out of the lake. Then they again added wood to the fire. This time the hawk went to the lion for help. What happened when the pelican is trying to put up the fire? What happened? They added more firewood. That means more sticks. They added more sticks. What will happen? If they add more sticks, the fire will be raised. You know that? The fire will be raised. So the pelican is going near the lake and bringing the water and pouring on the fire. What will happen? Again and again it is doing. That's why the pelican get tired. That's why hawk went to the tortoise and asked the tortoise, will you lend me helping hand? That means, will you help me? The they made a fire. Who made a fire? Tribes, hunters made a fire. Because of that heat, my children will be dead. Okay. Already pelican is helping, but it was tired by bringing the water. Could you please help me? Like that, hawk asked the tortoise. So what did the tortoise this time? Tortoise brought some of the mud in his mouth and put up on the fire. But what happened? They are adding more firewood to the fire. So the fire again raging and raging. And by seeing the tortoise, what the hunters did? If the hunters wanted animals, no? So they saw one of the large tortoise, which is large. It is a big tortoise. So the tortoise brought mud to put up the fire. That's when the tortoise came out of the lake. The tortoise living in the lake. So So I'll put up this file. The data is came out from the lake. Okay. The data is came out from the lake. It brought mud in his mouth to put up this file. Okay. So when the tortoise came outside to put up this file, what happened? The hunters, the tribal people saw the large tortoise and they wanted to catch the tortoise. By seeing the tortoise, they wanted to catch the tortoise. But the tortoise is, okay, listen, don't text me, first listen. So when the tortoise came out from the lake, what happened? The hunters wanted to catch the tortoise, but the tortoise is huge tortoise, that means a big tortoise. So it dragged the hunters into the water. The tortoise dragged those, drag means took them into the water. Okay. The tortoise pulled those hunters into the water. So when the tortoise pulled those hunters into the water, what happened? They drenched. Drenched means get wet. So if the people go inside the water, what will happen? We also get wet. Am I right? So like that, the tortoise is a big tortoise. That's why the people came to catch the tortoise. But the tortoise is so big, so it pulled those people into the water. So when they go into the water, they became wet. They drenched. So when they became wet, they came out. They left the tortoise there and they came outside again. But because those are the cold days, okay, those are the cold days. If they get wet, what will happen? They will shiver. Okay, that's why those people left the tortoise there only and they came back. By seeing that, this time hawk went to take help from lion. Okay, take help from lion. This time hawk went to his friend lion to take helping hand from the lion. So we will see here what will happen next. Soon, the lion came roaring up to them. On seeing the lion, the frightened tribal hunters fled from the spot. Though the hawk's friends proved their true friendship. So, the third time, hawk went to the lion for its helping hand. So, it asked the help to the lion. And by listening that story, the lion came roaring to the hunters. Onto the hunters. So when the hunters saw the lion, they ran away. They fled means ran away. The hunters ran away so that the young babies are safe. Okay. By seeing the lion, the hunters ran away from the forest. And the young hawks saved from the hunters. Okay. Did you understand now? Did you understand the story? Is it interesting? Yes. Shall I revise the story again? Story completed. I will read the ones. Okay. So, what are the characters of the story? Hawk, she-hawk, tortoise, pelican, lion, tribal people, and young hawks. That means baby hawks. Okay. Hawk means bird, one of the birds. She-hawk means ladybird. Okay. That means this is the boy, this is the girl. Okay. And these are the children. Did you understand now? So, once what happened? Hawk wanted to marry a she-hawk. Okay, he wanted to marry she-hawk. For that, it went to the she-hawk and asked her, will you marry me? Then she-hawk said, do you have friends? Then hawk said, I don't have any friends. Then go and make friends. Then I will marry you. Then hawk went to the tortoise and made friendship with the tortoise. Next, it went to the pelican and it also made friendship with the pelican. Next, it went to the lion. It also made friendship with the lion. So, what happened? After this, they become friends. The hawk came to the she-hawk and asked, now I have three friends, tortoise, pelican, lion. Will you marry me? Then she-hawk accepted to marry hawk. Soon they got married and they also have children. They made nest on the tree which is near the lake. where tortoise is living. So one day what happened, the tribal people came for hunting. They did not get any bird or any animal to catch. So they get tired. They wanted to take rest. That's why they came under the tree which where the birds are living. So they came, those are the cold days, that's why they made fire. So because of the fire, because of the heat, the young hawks are screeching. So by listening the sound, the hunters wanted to raise that fire so that the birds will be cooked. Then they will eat easily. So by seeing that hawk wanted to take help from the pelican. It went to the pelican and asked that, "Will you help me? My children are chirping because of they are unable to bear the heat." So what the pelican did, it brought water in its beak and tried to put out the fire. But what happened? The hunters again and again they are raising the fire by adding more firewood. So because of the fire, it was the pelican is a smaller bird, so it can't put up the fire. That's why by seeing that the pelican was getting tired, so hawk went to the tortoise for its helping hand. So it requested to the tortoise, "Already pelican is helping, but it is unable to put up the fire. Will you help me?" Then tortoise came from the water. It brought mud in its mouth and tried to put up the fire. But by seeing the tortoise, the hunter wanted to catch the tortoise. But the tortoise is biggest tortoise. That's why it pulled those hunters into the water. So when it pulled those hunters into the water, they get wet. So they left the tortoise there only and they came back to the fire. So the tortoise also unable to help the hawk. This time, hawk went to the lion for help. So the lion came by roaring unto the tribals. So by seeing the lion, the tribal people ran away. So in that way, these three friends helped the hawk. So now tell me, these three are called the true friends or not? Tortoise, pelican, lion are true friends or not? Yes, these three are the true friends. Why? Because when hawk is in the troubles, these three helped it. Okay, that's why these three, tortoise, pelican, lion are called true friends. Okay, did you understand the story? Okay, all of you read that story, okay? Not now, it goes. After completion of the class, okay? Now I'll write new words. Write in your notebook. Okay? Reading. First word, hawk. Pelican. Next, befriended. Befriended means make friendship with someone. Tribal. Searching. Searching. Next. Prey. Prey means animal is a food of other animal. Great. Screech. Screech means crying. Cry of a bird. Flame. Dogs. Dogs means put up. Dravid. Dravid means full. Vaichire. So what is the meaning of Vaichire? That means get rich. Fled. Fled means ran away. Happiness. Happiness means feel happy. Okay? Listen here once, read this word. Hawk, pelican, befriended, tribal, searching, prey, screech, play, doubts, dragon, drenched, fled, happiness. Okay? Write those words. All of you read the story once, 3 times, okay? Read the lesson 3 times and you also learn these spellings, okay? Learn these spellings, write 2 times in your notebook and learn these spellings. I hope you understand today's session. Thank you.